Okay, so here's a Hess's law example that we can look at. We are going to calculate the delta H reaction, so the enthalpy of reaction for this reaction right here. That's our target. And we are given two reactions to work with, so reaction one here and reaction two here. So we can use those to calculate this delta H reaction for our target reaction. Okay? So, the general strategy to this is to look at each reaction individually and see if the reactants and products that are in the target reaction in this reaction that we're looking at, we want to see if they're on the correct sides of the equation, so are they reactants, products, as shown in the target, and then we also want to look at those coefficients and see if we need to multiply or divide any of those coefficients. Or multiply and divide the entire reaction, which would change those coefficients. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at the first reaction, okay? And so when we compare the first reaction, we can see that copper is on the correct side of the equation, okay? The other species that is actually in this target reaction is copper oxide. And so there we can see that that's on the correct side of the equation. So now we know that everything's on the right side of the equation, so we don't need to flip this reaction. But what do we need to do? Look at those coefficients, okay? So we have in our target reaction, we actually have 4 moles of copper solid, okay? And we only have 1 in our reaction that we're working with. So what we want to do is multiply that entire reaction, so multiply each coefficient by 4, and then we also need to multiply our delta H reaction by 4. So let's go ahead and do that, okay? So we're going to multiply this by 4. Okay, so that's going to give us 4 copper plus, so 1/2 times 4, that's going to be 2 oxygen gas, okay? And then we're going to end up with 4 copper oxide, copper 2 oxide, okay? And then our delta H reaction, our new one, is going to be 4 times what it originally was, which is -157.3 kilojoules per mole. Okay. All right, so there we have our first reaction that we have dealt with. Let's go ahead and do the multiplication here. And so I'm going to do that in a different color. So 4 times -157, so if you put that in your calculator, you're going to get -629.2 kilojoules per mole. Okay. All right, so that's reaction one. All right, so now let's turn our attention to reaction two, okay? And so if we look at this reaction, I might be drawn to nitrogen dioxide. So we can see that nitrogen dioxide is a reactant in our target reaction, but in the reaction that we're given, it is a product, okay? So that would lead us to think that we should flip this reaction or reverse it. And the other thing, we could have also looked at nitrogen gas, which also is on the wrong side of the equation. So let's go ahead and flip that guy, flip it first, okay? And I'm going to leave a little bit of room because you might know what's coming next, okay? So nitrogen dioxide, yes. Okay, that is going to go to 1/2 and 2 gas plus oxygen gas, okay? And since we reversed the reaction for our delta H reaction, we're going to want to reverse that, okay? So now we're going to end up with negative 33.18 kilojoules per mole. Okay, all right, so we have that. That doesn't look like an 8, so let's go ahead and, yeah, that looks pretty bad. All right, let's do, do, do. Okay, so let me go back and make an 8. Okay, All right, so there we have that reaction. Now it's on, everything's on the correct side now, but we still have a problem with our coefficients. Okay, so move this oxygen over a little bit. Okay, and what is that? Okay, so we see that we have 1 mole of nitrogen gas in our target reaction, but we only have a half in the reaction we're working with. Same with nitrogen dioxide, we have 2 moles in our target and only 1 in the reaction we're working with. So we need to multiply all these coefficients by 2. So let's go ahead and do that. So multiply everything by 2, okay? So this is going to give us 1, of course, and then that's going to be 2. Okay, and then so let me go ahead and write that down also. So the reaction 2, we reversed it. And multiply by 2. Okay? And you might be thinking I forgot something. And if you were thinking that, you'd be right, because we also need to multiply our reversed value of delta H reaction by 2. Okay? And so in a different color, if we do that, we're going to have -66.36 kilojoules per mole. Okay? All right. So let's go ahead and add these guys together. Okay, so maybe I'll switch to purple for that. Okay. All right, so let's look at what we can cancel out, and I definitely see that we can cancel out oxygen gas. All right. See anything else to cancel out? All right, so when we add these two reactions together, we should come up with our target reaction. So we're going to check that. Okay, so we have 4 copper solid. Okay, we have 2 nitrogen dioxide. Okay, on the product side, we have 4 copper oxide. Okay. And we have 1 nitrogen gas. Okay, so if we look up at our target reaction, this matches, so that's great. Okay, and our final step is to just add up these 2 delta H reactions, the 2 individual ones, add those together, and that will be our new delta H reaction. Okay, so delta H reaction for our target reaction is -629. Plus -66.36, okay? And so on the next slide, I'll go ahead and write that down, get our final answer. Okay, so our delta H reaction was -629.2 kilojoules per mole. And then we're adding them together, but of course it's just like subtracting, because we're going to add a negative number, -66.36 kilojoules per mole. Okay, and we're going to end up with -695.56 kilojoules per mole. Okay, so there's your Hess's Law example, one of them. I will try to get to it to post some more.